Hello everyone, and welcome to the Sabre Virtual Demo, our brief videos explaining different features of Business Central and related products. In this episode, we're going to look at Phantom BOMs, or bills of material, in Business Central. All right, I'm logged into Business Central, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at a product design. So we're going to start by looking at some bills of material, production bills of material that we've created. And one of the bills of material we created is a repair kit. This is a bicycle repair kit. And in it, I have three items. I have a travel bike wrench, a tire inner tube, and a belt. I have one travel bike wrench, two tubes, and one belt. Now, this is obviously a spare belt. If I look at the bicycle itself, I have a production BOM that's a type of line that's been added to the bicycle's bill of material, and that is the repair kit. Now, notice there is already a bell on this bill of material, and remember that there is a bell in the repair kit. So let's see what happens when I create a production order for to make a bicycle. So I'll create a new production order. This is going to copy the bill of material from the bicycle. I'll tab off this because I need to get a next production order number. The source number is going to be 1000, which is my bicycle. And my quantity, I'll just make one. And what we're going to see when I process this and refresh this production order, which is going to go in, it's going to look at the routings and the component requirements for a bicycle, draw those into this order, and generate this production order. All right, so now I have a production order with a scheduled start and end date based on the routing requirements. And if I go into the components on this bicycle, now what I find is I have two tire inner tubes. My bill of material for my repair kit included two tire inner tubes. I have one travel bike wrench, which was on that bill of material. For some reason, I have two bells. Well, the basic bill of material for a bicycle includes a bell, and my repair kit includes a bell. But you'll notice that the repair kit itself does not exist anywhere on this bill of material, this component list of the actual order, the production order that was created. So what it's done is it's inserted these components by just having the bill of material present on the master. And we'll go back to the product design quickly and look at that again. So if I go to the bicycle, I have a bill of material production BOM on my master that is removed. And instead of seeing something called a repair kit, what I see is I see the components of the repair kit. This is referred to as a phantom part, and it's very common in ERP in general. Thank you for watching our videos. Please follow our channel by clicking here. Or click here for more great videos. We look forward to seeing you next time.